Student, now we will learn some properties of multiplication. We have learned the properties of subtraction and addition. Now there are certain properties of multiplication also that you have to keep in the mind. So the first property is multiplicative property of one, or it is also known as multiplicative identity property, or we can say identity property also. Okay, it is same as additive identity or additive property of 1. So when a number is multiplied by 1, we are multiplying a number by 1, the product is number itself. We can take any number, if we multiply it by 1, we get the same number. That's why it is known as identity property. We have studied in addition also that if it gives the same number, then it is called identity property. So here are the example: 8 multiplied by 1 is 8, we got the same number. 213 multiplied by 1, 213, we got the same number. We can multiply any number, any large number or small number, we will get the same result. So our second property is multiplicative property of 0. Okay, it is also known as zero property. So when a number is multiplied by 0, the product is 0 always. As we have seen that if we multiply any number by 0, we always get the product as 0. We always get the result as 0 always. So now the third property is commutative property. This property we have also studied in addition. So it is same as that property. So according to this property, if we change, it is also known as order property. If we change the order of the numbers, the product remains same. This is known as commutative property of multiplication. Now there we were adding, now we are multiplying over here, and we have to change the order also. So look over here, 34 into 3 gives me 72. Even if I change the order, if I keep 3 at first place and 34 at other place, I have changed the order, so then also I will get the same product. 200 multiplied by 5, 1000 hi hoga, और 5 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 200 भी 1000 ही होगा. तो प्रोडक्ट सेम रहेगा इवन इफ ऑर्डर चेंज हो जाता है. स्टूडेंट, लेट अस सी द नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज द एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन. इट इज आल्सो नोन एज ग्रुपिंग प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन. इट इज सेम एज द एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ एडिशन, वी हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस प्रॉपर्टी, इफ वी रीग्रुप एंड चेंज द ऑर्डर ऑफ नंबर्स, देन द प्रोडक्ट रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड. ओके, दैट मीन्स अगर हम रीग्रुप और या फिर ऑर्डर चेंज कर देते हैं नंबर का, देन ऑलवेज द प्रोडक्ट रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड. इट डज नॉट चेंज, प्रोडक्ट रिमेन्स सेम. सी, लेट अस सी हाउ वी रीग्रुप और चेंज द ऑर्डर. सो हियर थ्री नंबर्स आर मल्टीप्लाइड ओवर हियर. सो फर्स्ट वी कैन ग्रुप these two numbers and leave this one, as I have grouped these two and left this one, and I will multiply and I will get the product. Now what I will do, I will leave 60 and regroup 8 into 100. Okay, so this is, in this way I have regrouped the numbers and multiplied and got the product. Now what I will do, I will change the order. I will keep 100 over here and 8 to the next place, and I will group them. So I have grouped 16 to 100 and then I have multiplied and I have got the same product. As you can see, in any order, if we regroup or change the order of the numbers, the product is same in all the three cases. This is known as associative property of multiplication. Now let us see very important property, that is the fifth property, distributive property of multiplication. So this property is very important, as in sixth class also you are going to use this property for whole numbers. So let us now study the statement. A number can be expressed as a sum or difference of two or more numbers to multiply it easily. This is the distributive property of multiplication over addition or subtraction. So what we have to do in this property, we have to take any number and that can be expressed as a sum or difference. So that number can be expanded as a sum or as a difference of two or more numbers so that our multiplication becomes easier. So this is distributive property of multiplication over addition if we are expressing in the form of addition, or if we are subtracting, expressing in the form of subtraction, so it will be multiplication over subtraction. So let us see the general rule to understand it better. A, B, C be any number. Let us suppose that A, B and C are any number. Now what are A, B and C? A, B and C are known as variables. Variables का मतलब क्या होता है? कि variables ऐसे letters होते हैं जो जिनको हम रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं एंड दे हैव सर्टन न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यूज. ओके, लाइक ए कैन बी 12, बी कैन बी 30 एंड सी कैन बी 5. इट देयर वैल्यूज चेंज एज पर आर चॉइस और एज पर द नंबर गिवन. एंड 1, 2, 3 दीज नंबर्स आर नोन एज कॉन्स्टेंट. दीज आर गोइंग यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी लेटर ऑन. सो एज पर दिस रूल, सपोज दीज आर एनी नंबर, सो ए इंटू बी प्लस सी, दिस इज मल्टी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव प्रॉपर्टी ओवर एडिशन. वी आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग द numbers, so it will be, we will, what we will do, we will first multiply A with B, then we will multiply A with C. Plus sign is there, we will put plus sign, A into B, A into C. Now in second one also, first we are going to multiply A with B, then we will put minus sign and we will multiply A into C. In this manner we can use distributive property of multiplication. We will also see some examples of it. Let's look an example of distributive property over here. Here a number is given, 281 multiplied by 95, and we have to use the distributive property. So what we will do, we have to express 95 in the form of plus or minus, in the form of subtraction or addition. So it is easy for writing as 95 in the form of subtraction, that is 100 minus 5. See, you can also write 281, but what you will do, if you will express, then it will be 200 plus 81 and you will have to multiply by 81. It will be very uncomfortable. So what you can do, you can just take the easier number that is easy to multiply, like in hundreds, or it is a smaller number. Now as per the property, this will be our A and these are going to be B, and these are, this is going to be C. So A into B plus B minus C is A into B and then A into C. So this is A into B. Okay, 281 multiplied by 100. We will multiply with B first, then we will take A and we will multiply it with C later on. Okay, so we will put the minus sign, as here is the minus sign. 281 into 100 is 281 hundred, and minus 281 into 5 is 1405. When we will subtract, we will get the answer as 26695. It is easier method than multiplying the number by 95. Okay, we have expressed in the form of subtraction. It is easy to multiply in hundreds and by a smaller digit of number. So look over here, the next example. So here the number is 415 multiplied by 1005. So it is easy for us to expand 1005 and express in the form of addition. So 1005 can be written as 1000 plus 5. So as we did earlier, this will be A, this will be B, and this will be our C. Okay, these are variables and these are their numerical values. Now A into B, we multiplied first. Okay, A into B, 450 into 1000, then we will, as there is plus sign, so we will put plus sign and don't forget to enclose in the brackets. Okay, now we will multiply A into C. So what we will get into B is 415,000 plus 415 into 5 is 2075, and we will add, we will get this result. Okay, this will be our answer. So in this way, whether you can express in the form of addition or in the form of subtraction, and you can use the distributive property and multiply a number.